Phones these days are capable of taking beautiful portrait shots. Not every phone comes with a telephoto lens that lets you take your portrait photos up a notch. No pun intended. So in this video, we'll be faking focal length or the portrait effect in PicsArt. This effect works very well for portraits, but if you want, you can try it with objects as well. When photographing, make sure you take two shots. One with your subject in frame and one with just the background. This will make things easier and the end result will be much more pleasing. I will, however, show you how to do this with a single image at the end of the video. So first we will open up our browser and go to Remove.bg. If you've never heard of this website before, prepare your brain to implode. Tap Browse and select your image with your subject in it. Wait for the robots to do their thing, and once it's done, you will have your image with transparent background ready to be downloaded. Now this is a great way to remove background from your image, but unfortunately the output it produces is in much lower quality and the site only works with images with people in it. So I would recommend taking the long route and doing this manually. In PicsArt, choose your photo and go to cutout. Make selection of your image, then tap save. Your selection will now be saved as a sticker, so you don't have to save it as an image. Now that we have a cutout of your foreground subject, let's open up a sample image of the background that I downloaded from Unsplash. I didn't take any photo of my own because I am allergic to people, so sorry about that. Go to Effects, Blur, and select Lens Blur. Adjust it to your liking. Do not add too much blur to the point that you don't even see what's in the background. Around 15 and 25 is a good spot. Same goes for lighting as well. Once you have done that, tap the tick icon and save the background image to your gallery. Go back and tap Pick Canvas. Tap Drawn Photo and select your background image that we just saved. Skip Crop and tap the tick icon. You will see why we're doing this in Draw and not in the main editor in just a second. Tap Layers and with the empty layer selected, tap the color icon next to Blending Options. Select any color you want. Move the background layer to the top and decrease its opacity. Zoom out of your canvas to about 10% so we can see our working area. Tap three dots in the layer panel and select Transform with the background layer selected. We added color to that empty layer because we can now see our canvas in the background. Scale your background image up and reposition it. Once you're done, tap the tick icon. We could have done this simply by cropping our background photo and adding our cutout on top in the main editor. But that would downscale our image, which will make it look blocky and it will not look great. But in this case, we have a canvas that does not change its resolution. After you have repositioned and scaled your background, you can reset its opacity back to 100. Tap plus icon on the bottom and select your cutout foreground image. If you use the website, choose photo, and if you did manual selection, tap stickers and select your cutout. Reposition and scale it. And that concludes our first way of creating this effect with two images. Next, I'm going to show you how to do this with a single image. Keep in mind, doing this with a single image will not look as natural as doing it with two images. It might not work well in some scenes, which you'll see in a minute. If you're finding this video useful so far, consider subscribing if you're interested in more videos like this one. I never like asking for likes and subscribers, but it's just the YouTuber nerves, you know. It eventually gets to you when you get this far into it. Anyway, import your image and go to cutout. Now, instead of selecting your subject in the foreground, select the background instead. Tap save when you have it selected. Then select your foreground image and save it as a sticker as well. Go to Tools and select Stretch. Now this part is going to be tricky. What we need to do now is fill in the foreground cutout with our background by pushing the outer pixels inwards, because we will be adding blur to this. It doesn't matter if it is not perfect, what you do need to keep in mind is stretching in a line. That means if there is a straight line of something going one way, you stretch it so it completes that line. I really suck at explaining, don't I? You also don't need to finish the whole thing unless you are planning on zooming in way too close. Once you're done, save this image to your gallery. And from here, we edit it just the way we did with two images. Go back to the timestamp that's on your screen right now and follow the tutorial from there. And that does it for this video. If you've enjoyed this video, be sure to leave a like, subscribe, and check out more PicsArt tutorials in the end card. Thank you so much for watching. I will see you in the next video. Peace out.